So to find out what happens when we run this line of code, we will go back in time and look at a video from a previous lesson when we were drawing shapes.
For now, you can think of a class as a neatly packaged box that puts things together really well. And it allows us to write code like turtle.turtle with these strange looking brackets as if we were calling a function. In fact, when we do run this piece of code, we are in fact calling a function called init, which is defined inside the class turtle. Init stands for initialize. And what it does is it creates space in memory for a new instance or a new object of the class turtle. This instance we called Brad.
Okay, so we are back to the present time. Now, we started out by defining a file called media.py. Let me place it up on the board. Notice that I placed this file outside the Python standard library. Inside that file, we then defined a class called movie. After that, we wrote a line of code that said media.movie. And what that did was that it called the init function defined inside class movie. And that created a new instance. That instance we called Toy Story. So to summarize, this function init initializes or creates space in memory for the new instance Toy Story. By the way, this function init is also called a constructor because it constructs space in memory for the new instance, which in this case happens to be Toy Story. So thus far, we've encountered two new words that we can add to our new word list. The first one is instance, which in this case happens to be Toy Story. And the second one is a constructor, which in this case is the function init. Now we will revisit these words soon. For now, let's define init.